obviously it's very difficult to observe the unconscious mind. What do you see as its role in our lives? And is there a way to actively engage or understand it?
So I really think that sort of counterintuitively, our unconscious is really, it takes center stage. It is the main driver of our behavior and our thoughts. And, you know, we're only consciously aware of a very little bit about what's happening in the brain. Most of it is happening unconsciously. So it has a very significant role in our lives and ways that we can sort of, you know, so it's always engaged, but ways that we can sort of bring it into consciousness or become more aware of our unconscious processes. There are a number of ways. One is which, you know, getting into these flow states, these creative flow states, where you lose your sense of time and place and self, daydreaming, you know, certain drugs can get you there, meditation, and in dreams, where you kind of lower parts of your brain that have to do with like your defenses that are suppressing the unconscious processes, like keeping them at bay. Because if you're aware of everything happening behind the scenes, it would be overwhelming, it'd be too much stimulation. So you want there to be a filter. But when you get into these brain states where the filter is kind of released, it allows you access to some of these unconscious processes and gives you insights. And psychotherapy is another way to try to delve into the unconscious. You know, you're in a relaxed setting. It allows you to like reach into those sort of maybe uncomfortable memories or emotions in a neutral environment, in a safe environment, and access some of the things that are motivating your behavioral patterns and your thoughts, and that maybe you can change it and not repeat the same mistakes over and over again.